Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we are again going to look at a budget laptop primarily targeted towards students or also for general purpose use in home. So this laptop sells for under $330. I will throw a link in the description on Amazon. You can check out the price. The price varies little bit, but it is right around $300 or under $330. So the reason I am picking this laptop is, first, it is a great value for the money that you are paying. So for $330, you are getting a laptop which has very good performance, and it's a good laptop overall. But the second thing, which is more important in my opinion, is the upgrade potential. This laptop has some very good potential, and if you are willing to open the back of the laptop, if you are willing to be little brave and go and do little surgery on the laptop. And I will give all the details in this video. And with these upgrades, this laptop will become an absolute steal for the price. So this laptop comes with a 15.6 inch screen. It's a full HD display, 1920 by 1080. And this is an IPS panel, so it will have a great viewing angles. And also this is LED backlit display. So this is actually a pretty good display for the price. For this price point, a lot of times you have cheap, some of the laptops use the cheaper TN panel, which means the text and the image quality deteriorates if the viewing angle is not very good. That's not the case with this laptop. The image quality, the text is very sharp. The pictures look good. The videos also look fine on this laptop. More importantly, at skewed angle, the brightness of the screen is still decent. Talking about brightness, it's around 227 nits, and if you look at the comparison with other laptops in this price category, it's actually right on the top. 227 nits of brightness is good enough for any kind of indoor use. So whether you are in classroom or whether you are in a bright lit office environment or in home environment, you will have no problem using the laptop. Now don't expect to take this laptop out in bright sunlight and watch a movie or something like that, because that's not going to work. But for a $330 laptop, I think the screen is very good. So one point to note is that this screen is not touch enabled. That means you don't get any touch support. Also, you will not have any stylus support. Now let's talk about the build quality of this laptop. So this laptop is polycarbonate, or plastic in simple English, and the build quality is okay. What I like is that Acer has done some elegant enhancements on the the material. For example, the touchpad has a chrome surrounding, which kind of looks very cool. Also, the lid has this etching, which gives it a very refined look. So overall, the looks of this laptop is it definitely makes it look more expensive than what the price is. And overall, the build quality is fine. When you hold the laptop in your hands, it feels pretty solid. It is 5 pounds in weight, so that puts it on a little heavier side. But you have to keep in mind that this laptop has a DVD drive, which most of the lighter laptops don't have that. And also it has a much bigger battery. So Acer is claiming to have a 13.5 hours of battery life. As far as the overall build quality of this laptop is concerned, for this price point, I think it's pretty good. So this laptop comes with an Intel Core i3 processor. This is an 8th generation processor. Specifically, the processor is 8130U. So this is a Kaby Lake processor. It's a 2-core, 4-thread processor with a base clock frequency of 2.2 gigahertz. The CPU is capable of overclocking itself automatically, and it can clock itself all the way to 3.4 gigahertz. So that's the turbo clock frequency. And if you're not familiar with the turbo clock frequency, what Intel CPUs are capable of doing is that if there is sudden, workload demand, the CPU can overclock itself and go and perform the task and then come back to the base frequency. And it does all this while retaining the thermal envelope, so your the CPUs don't get overheated, and as a result there is no thermal throttling. So let's look at the CPU benchmark. This CPU scores 5028 points in the average CPU mark, and the CPU mark relative to the most common laptops, it sits somewhere in the middle. Interestingly, it is actually ahead of some of the Core i5 processors from Intel, which are the M processors. So this is a U processor, which is an ultra light processor. So this is for laptops with very good battery life, and it's clocked at 2.2 gigahertz. And surprisingly, this processor is performing better than the Core i5s, like the Core i5 3230M. So performance is pretty good. Now let's look at the overall performance of the laptop. So this is not just the CPU, but the overall performance, the CPU, GPU, your hard drives, everything. This is the Geekbench 4.1. Here you see that the laptop scores 7871 and it is actually pretty good. The best way to look at this chart is to look at the category average. So category average is the laptops which are around $300 to $400 price point, and these laptops tend to score around 4859 points. Acer Aspire E15 is scoring 7871, so it's exceeding, you know, expectations. The performance that you are getting out of this laptop is very good, and mind you, this is the performance just out of the box. I will show you how you can dramatically improve the performance with some minor upgrades, and so we will cover that later in the video. But right out of the box, the performance is very good. So this laptop comes with 6 GB of system RAM, which is good enough for Windows 10. In my opinion, Windows 10 performs better when you have more than 4 GB of memory, so 6 GB is definitely good. More would be welcome, and we will talk about how you can upgrade. But starting with 6 GB of RAM is pretty good for a budget laptop. 6 GB of memory means you can run multiple applications, or for example, if you are running Firefox browser or Chrome browser and you have a bunch of tabs, you will be easily able to switch between these tabs and the pages are not going to reload. You will instantaneously switch between multiple applications. So it's going to be a very good performance. Also, the integrated graphics that you get with this laptop, it's the UHD 620 Intel internal graphics. This particular chipset is actually good because it has the built-in hardware acceleration for all the popular codecs. So for example, what YouTube, Google uses something called VP9 codec, and Netflix uses something called H265. These two codecs are hardware accelerated. So what that means is that the GPU is able to decode these video streams in the graphics processing unit. It does not have to use the CPU. So in simple English, that means when you are watching a 4K video on say YouTube, or if you are streaming something on Netflix, you are going to get very smooth performance. There will be no frames dropped and it will be a pleasant experience. You can also use this laptop to do simple gaming. So for example, Fortnite will play nicely on this laptop. Most of the casual games you can play without any problem. Obviously, if you are thinking of playing some high-end games at insane frames per second, that's not going to work. This is after all a budget laptop, it's not a gaming laptop, so you know the expectations need to be aligned with the the price of the laptop. Okay, now let's talk about the upgrading, right? That's the part I wanted to talk about and I alluded to at the beginning of the video. So this laptop comes with a hard disk instead of SSD. And hard disks are the old school hard drives. They have a spinning wheel, and this particular hard drive is 5200 RPM, so that's 5200 rotations per minute. And these hard drives are old school hard drives. They make a lot of noise, so your laptop is noisy. They also consume more battery because you are literally spinning the wheel while you are using the laptop, and their read and write speeds are not comparable to the modern SSDs. So this is the bottleneck as far as this laptop is concerned with respect to performance. So if you are comfortable opening the back of the laptop, and it's not very difficult, there are like half a dozen screws that you have to unscrew, and that will give you access to the back of laptop. It's not very complicated. You don't have to solder anything. You don't need to do anything complicated. Just unscrew the back and you have access to the SSD slot, and you also have access to the memory slots. And then you can go and upgrade these components. So I will throw a link in the description about like a compatible SSD which you can put, and I will also throw a link of the compatible memory modules that you can buy, or check the prices on Amazon to see if it makes sense for you to do that. I have upgraded many laptops, and it's not that complicated. It's actually pretty easy. It's kind of like an adult Lego kind of thing, because these components like the memory module or SSD, they just fit nicely in a slot. You don't need to connect any wires. There is no soldering, so it is doable. So once you do the upgrade, say for example you put an SSD, and SSD is basically a faster drive. It's not mechanical. You don't have any spinning wheel or anything, and you don't need to remove the older hard drive. So you can put the new SSD. So after you do that, your computer will boot from the SSD and it will be much faster. Your suspend, resume, your hibernation, everything will be fast. And more importantly, your old hard disk will still be there. So you still have that 1 terabyte of space. And now you can use that space to save your documents, your videos, photos, you know, your stuff you are recording from your camera, your pictures, you can all put that in the hard disk. And you can use the SSD for the operating system and for, you know, installing applications. And you can also increase the memory if you want to. So there are 2 slots, right? So you can put 16 gigabyte in each slot and that will give you 32 gigabyte of memory. You don't have to. 6 gigabyte is actually good enough in my opinion, but if you want, you can increase that. So with these upgrades, your laptop is going to punch way above its weight, right? It's a $330 laptop. You can check the price of the SSD and the memory modules. I will throw a link in the description. So you can do the math and come up with the total price. It will still be under $400. And for that price, you will get a laptop which will be performing at the level of an $800 laptop. So I think this is a fantastic deal when you do the upgrades. Now, if you don't do the upgrades or if you're not comfortable doing the upgrades, then also it's a decent laptop, but just remember that it doesn't have a SSD, it has a hard disk, so it will feel little slower. Another important thing in all traditional laptops is the port support, and Acer has again done a very good job with the port selection. So you get all the traditional USB ports. So this is the old school USB type A port. You get the USB 2.0 port, you get the USB 3.0 port. In addition to these ports, you get the modern Type-C USB 3.1 port. And then you have HDMI, you even have a VGA port, which is, you know, connecting to an old school monitor. There is an Ethernet port if you want to connect to, you know, a wired connection for internet. You have a headphone jack and you also have a SD card slot. So all the bases are covered, and you know, thumbs up to Acer for giving all the ports. I hate companies which like skimp on port in the name of modern laptop design, and I'm, you know, talking about Apple. So if you have like one USB type C port and that's it, that's really stupid. So I'm very happy with the port selection on this laptop. So let's talk about the keyboard and the trackpad. So these two are very important in my opinion for any laptop. If the keyboard or the trackpad is busted, then in my opinion that laptop is dead on arrival. Luckily for us, Acer has done a good job with the keyboard. You are getting a full size keyboard, which means you are getting the numeric pad, and the keys are actually nicely spaced and the typing experience is very good. The key travel is around 1.1 millimeter, which in my opinion is little on the lower side. And you know, I would have preferred the key travel to be little longer. I'm old school guy, so I like when I'm pressing, I want the keys to travel a lot. 1.1 is still fine. It's just a personal choice, but you know, I would have preferred little more. But on the bright side, the actuation force of the keys, which is basically when you press the key, how much resistance you feel, that is really nice. This one has around 72 grams of actuation force, and any keyboard which gives more than 60 grams of actuation key feels really nice when you type, because you get that nice tactile feedback. So overall the keys are very good, and similarly the trackpad is also really nice. The trackpad is really large. It's 4.1 by 3 inches, so that's a pretty good size trackpad. It's not as huge as say a Mac Pro, but it's still, you know, for a Windows laptop, I think the trackpad size is pretty good. Acer has made some nice aesthetic choices. So the trackpad has this nice chrome trim around it, which makes it look really nice, because this laptop is black in color and that chrome trim makes it look really elegant. The trackpad comes with the Windows 10 Precision drivers. So these drivers are really, you know, they first of all, they offer multi-touch support. So you have like pinch zoom thing is there. You have 2-finger, 3-finger and 4-finger, you know, gesture support. You have like simple gestures like, you know, scrolling up and down, and also complicated gestures which you can customize. So overall, the keyboard and the trackpad both are really good. Okay, so to summarize everything, here is my final conclusion. I would say that for $330, this is a very good laptop, and even without any upgrades or any kind of modification, I think you would be happy with this laptop. This would be a good laptop for students, or for like a, you know, home use or casual you know, usage. You can also do old school things like rip CDs if you have any, or you know, watch DVD, because it comes with a DVD drive, which is kind of interesting. But I think the, you know, the real bang for bucks is when you upgrade the laptop. So like I said before, I will drop a link to all the compatible memory modules and the SSD, and you can go and check the price on Amazon and see if it makes sense for you to upgrade these. I will also drop a link to the Acer video, the official support video, which shows exactly how you are supposed to upgrade these components step by step, and I think it makes it very easy for average folks to upgrade the laptop. Like I said before, you don't need to do any complicated soldering or, you know, connecting wires. It's a simple case of just unscrewing the back of the laptop and then just pushing the memory slots in the correct position, and that would be the end of it. So yeah guys, I think overall I will give this laptop a thumbs up. For $330, Acer has done a very good job with this laptop. So if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to ask me a question in the comment section. I will be more than happy to help you out. I will also answer any technical questions regarding, you know, the memory or SSD, or if you have any confusion, feel free to ask me those questions. If you like this video, then please like this video and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.